Class 9th. Today we are going to start with the independence of judiciary, which is a part of lesson 4, page 48. Main objectives: security of service, security of pay and allowances, no discussion in legislature on the conduct of judges, no practice after retirement, free decisions and degrees. Before discussion of the topic, we must know the following terms. Let democracy. Democracy means government of the people, for the people, by the people. Constitution, a set of rules and regulation according to which country is run. Parliament, highest law-making body. Financial implications, impact with respect to money. Consolidated fund, government account from where the salaries to the high officials are paid. Impeachment. Impeachment is a process followed to remove the high officials from their seat on the ground proved misbehavior or incapacity, addressed by each House of Parliament, supported by majority of each House of total membership and 2/3 of the members of the House present for voting. As you know, for a federal democracy, it is most important that the court of law should be independent to administer justice and to interpret the Constitution and the different laws passed by various legislatures from time to time. Independence of judiciary implies that neither the executive nor the legislature nor any government or private agency should be able to influence the judges in the course of their discharge of their duties as a judge. Such an independence of judiciary has been ensured in India by providing the following services like security of service, security of pay and allowances, no discussion in legislature of judiciary, full control over its procedure, no practice after retirement, free decisions and decrees. Discuss all such points one by one. Now let's come to reading part. Independence of the judiciary. For a successful federal democracy, it is most essential that courts of the law should be independent to administer justice and to interpret the Constitution and the different laws passed by the various legislatures from time to time. Independence of judiciary implies that neither the executive nor the legislature nor any government or private agency should be able to influence the judges in the course of their discharge of duties as a judge. Such an independence of the judiciary has been ensured in India by means of the following provisions like security of service, security of pay and allowances, no discussions on the legislature, full control over procedure, no practice after retirement, free decisions and decrees. It means the independence of Supreme Court in carrying out their work is ensured by providing security of tenure and security of pay and allowances of the judges. Beside, the independence of the Supreme Court is ensured by undertaking the following measures. Let us discuss one by one. The first point, security of service. Security of service is always the most important factor in deciding the behavior of any government servant. It is more so in the case of judges who have at time to give some bitter decisions in the interest of justice. If a judge is afraid of any service being terminated on the whim of an administrator or an agency, he will always like to please that the person or agency for the fair or foul means, with the result that he will become a partial in discharging his duty. It means judiciary is a system of court that interpret and protect the law by punishing those who disobey the laws. Sometimes the decisions are very strict, which are needed to maintain the law and order, being afraid of administration. Judge cannot give his decision under any influence. To safeguard the judges of Supreme Court and those of the High Court from any embarrassment, it has been provided in the Constitution that the judges of these courts shall be appointed by President but cannot be removed from office by him. only in the event of gross misbehavior, acting against the provisions of the constitution, corruption or misuse of office can be judged be removed from the service by means of impeachment by parliament. This procedure for impeachment is almost the same as followed in case of President of India. It means to safeguard the interest of judges of Supreme Court and High Court, President is empowered by constitution for their appointments. President can appoint the judge, but he cannot remove them from their seats. Judges of High Court and Supreme Court can be removed from their seats by the process of impeachment if they found guilty on the issues of incapacity, misconduct, misbehavior, and working against constitution. Impeachment means impeachment is a process followed to remove the high officials from their seats on the ground proved misbehavior or incapacity addressed by each house of the parliament, supported by majority of each house of total membership and 2/3 of the members of the house present for voting. Number 2, salary or pay and allowances. In order to make a judge desist means to stop from accepting bribes or falling a prey to such other financial implications, it is necessary that he should be paid very adequately and be ensured that no decision of the executive shall reduce it. The Constitution had ensured independence of judiciary by providing that expenditure in respect of salaries and allowances of the judges shall be charged on the Consolidated Fund of India. By specifying that the salaries and allowances payable to judges or their pension shall not be varied by Parliament to their disadvantages after their appointments, except under a proclamation of financial emergency. Judges of High Courts are paid very high salaries with free accommodation, communication, transportation and free travelling throughout India, with pension after retirement. In order to make judges to stop the illegal activities like accepting bribes or getting lured for something else, at present salary of the judge of Supreme Court is 2,50,000 per month. Moreover, Parliament cannot make any deductions to their disadvantages after their appointment except under the proclamation of the financial emergency. Financial emergency means a state when there is a shortage of money. Number 3. No discussion in the legislature on the conduct of judges. The Constitution provides that there should be no discussion on the conduct of Supreme Court judges in the Parliament except on the motion of an address to President for the impeachment of a judge. Likewise, no state is allowed to discuss the conduct of judge of Supreme Court regarding the performance of their duties. It means no discussion in the legislature on the conduct of judges. Judiciary is an independent organ of the government which protect the law. Nothing should be discussed in the Parliament on the conduct of Supreme Court judges, their duties and their performances. True, there is no discussion of the judges in the Parliament, but except on the motion of an address to the President for the impeachment. Next is full control over procedure of work and establishment. The Supreme Court and the High Court are free to decide their own procedure of work and their establishment. The condition of service of their employees are also determined by the courts. Such they are the Supreme Court and High Courts are not likely to be influenced by any outside agency. It means Supreme Court and High Court are independent for the establishment of their methods of working. Working conditions are also decided by courts. Judiciary is not working under any pressure and influence. Number 5. No practice after retirement. A judge of Supreme Court shall not plead or enact in any court or before any authority within the territory of India after retirement. A permanent judge of High Court shall not plead or act in a court or before any authority of India except the Supreme Court and High Court other than High Court in which he has held the office. Supreme Court judges are not allowed to do any practice in the Supreme Court. They can practice as advocate in the High Court. On the other side, High Court judges cannot do the practice as an advocate at very same High Court where was he worked as a judge. He can practice in Supreme Court and other High Courts except the High Court he was working as a judge. Free decisions and degrees. The judges are free to announce their decisions and degrees in the court chamber without any danger to their person, property or fame. Their decisions cannot be criticized in public or press. The personal safety of the judge is duty of the state and ensured at all cost. It means judgment and decisions are free without any danger of their person, property or their publicity. They are free to give their decisions without any pressure. The decision of judge cannot be challenged in public and media. It is very eminent duty of the state to provide personal safety to judge at all possible ways. Children, we have finished the lesson and you will have to do the related short questions and long questions. Learn the basic terms and kindly follow the SNAP homework. Thank you.